toddler dies in grandma's care, cops sickened when they learn what's in his sippy cup. A young toddler was in the care of his grandmother in Pickens, South Carolina, but that's when his life was taken from him. After the police were called to the scene and an investigation was launched, authorities were left sickened to learn what was in his sippy cup. Angela Denise Brewer, 46, was taking care of her 14-month-old grandson on October 17, 2014, when the boy became unresponsive, according to WSPA. As another family member began to perform CPR on the young child in a desperate attempt to save his life, the police were called and quickly arrived to help. Deputies arrived on the scene, and the child was immediately transported to the hospital by first responders. Unfortunately, it wasn't long before doctors made the devastating announcement that he had died. Because of the circumstances of his death, an autopsy was performed on the young boy's little body, and it unveiled quite the sick secret: the toddler had a lethal dose of oxycontin in his system. Sadly, it was soon discovered that his grandmother, Angela Denise Brewer, had placed the lethal dose inside his sippy cup. When the young boy took a sip of his juice, he unknowingly ingested the oxycontin, which would ultimately take his life. Most recently, the sick grandmother has been convicted of homicide by child abuse, according to Pix 11. She has been sentenced to 20 years in prison for killing her own grandson. It's a shame that this young boy lost his life at the hands of his own grandmother. Not only was he killed by someone who should have protected him at all costs, he was killed by someone who was supposed to enjoy his company and spoil him rotten. Clearly, this was not the case. Our world is becoming a truly sick place, where children can't even trust the people who should love them the most. Some kids are forced to live in abusive, broken, and utterly chaotic homes because there are monsters among us. Because of this, we must keep an eye out for these children. If we see something that is a bit unusual or creepy, it's better to be safe and say something than to be sorry that we didn't. Too many children have lost their lives too soon because of the disgusting people who are supposed to be caring for them. Although most people just need a short break from the stresses of raising a child, some people snap under the pressure. For anyone who feels like they need a load lifted off of their shoulders, there is always someone who is willing to step in and help. There's no need to harm a child, especially considering there are many people in the world who would do anything to have a child of their own. In fact, those same people and many more would be willing to step in and foster or adopt a child in need for that reason alone. Brewer will spend the next 20 years of her life behind bars, dealing with the fact that she killed her own grandchild. Although her punishment may not seem sufficient for what she did to her 14-month-old grandson, we can be at peace knowing that God will handle it. The young boy is now home in Jesus' arms and his grandmother is only getting closer to her eternal judgment day. God isn't going to like what she did to one of his innocent children.